standing in my room when I was a senior at Penn, holding my 15-foot-long laptop charger, thinking, how archaic is this? You know, it's 2011, we're using wireless devices, and I'm tethered to the wall, literally chained to the wall with this wire to charge it. And so I just started asking myself, okay, you know, well, how can we beam energy through the air? And I started thinking about things that I knew that beamed energy through the air. So I started very simply, like, thinking about the remote control. And so I thought, okay, well, how does a remote control talk to a TV? I knew absolutely nothing. And so I wondered, well, can I amplify the power of the remote control beam to actually charge a device? And that's not a good solution. So I went through the entire electromagnetic spectrum. And I was like, okay, well, there are all these different things that we could beam. We can beam everything from radio waves to gamma waves. But I soon realized that everything on the right half of the spectrum was too dangerous to beam. You know, you wouldn't want X-rays whizzing through your body just to be able to charge your phone. And everything on the left half of the spectrum, closer to radio waves, are either limited by the government or too inefficient. So you know, I did a little research on what other people were doing to wirelessly charged devices using things like induction. So if you're familiar with, you know, how you charge your electric toothbrush or something called the power mat, you place a device on a mat, and that wasn't good enough. You know, it was like, okay, well, why can't we move past that, you know, sort of zero distance to 1 foot space where it seemed like that's where the wireless power technologies were going. And so I started looking into harnessing ambient energy, and I found a device called a piezoelectric transducer, which converts physical vibration or physical impact into electricity. So for example, you could put it underneath a train. As the train goes by, you could harness the impact of that train moving by and collect some of that energy. So I thought to myself, well, if we can do this with physical impact, how can we figure out a way to induce vibration or impact through the air with something invisible? And so it occurred to me that sound does that. Sound travels through the air by vibrating air particles, and we could potentially use the same energy harvesting material to capture the vibration of sound as we do with physical impact. And so I decided to use ultrasound because you can't hear it. And so the concept was born.